Hello everyone, in this tutorial we are going to use Ornatrix to create a game ready hair style from hair cards modeling to UVs. Ornatrix have a very interesting set of tools that would help us to do this quickly and efficient. My model is ready, I have extract part of the mesh to use as distribution surface. But first, let me explain real quick some basic ideas of Ornatrix for new users. At the top, I have the Ornatrix shelf with all the operators that we are going to use to model our hair. I'm not going to explain all of them right now, only the ones that I'm going to use in this video. This is the operator stack. Here you have a list of the operators you are using at the moment. This is like the outliner for Ornatrix. Also, you can stack these windows to the sides if you want or leave it floating. Now, let me show you the operators that I'm going to use to accomplish this task. Add hair to selection. As the name suggests, this will add a hair preset to the selected geometry, including some operators to start grooming. Let's see what it does. As you can see, this adds some operators for us. From top to bottom, I have the scalp shape, which is my hair distribution surface, followed by guides from surface. This operator generates guides on top of the geometry. The settings here are pretty simple. You can change the distribution type, the guide count, guide length, and randomness. In Edit Strand, you have three editing modes: Edit Strand, Edit Control Points, and Brush Mode. In Edit Strands, you can select, delete, rotate guides, and plan new guides if you want. In Edit Control Points, you can control the guides using Maya's manipulation tools. And finally, you can use the brush mode to model the hair using the brushing tools like move, cut, length, and more. Also, you have some properties here to customize the brushes like effect selected only, brush size and intensity, mirror and mirror axis. And by the way, in the hair stack, you can right-click to delete, copy, or rename your nodes. The next operator is hair from guides. Here you have the distribution type and other hair distribution settings, viewport hair count, and render hair count. Then you have render settings to control the radius of the hair and radius ramp to control the shape. To create hair cards for real-time rendering, we have to convert the hair into geometry using the mesh from strands operator. With Ornatrix, you have full control of your hair cards by controlling the poly count, UVs and UV sets, for example. Here I'm going back to guide from mesh to change the point count of the guides to reduce or increase the poly count of the hair cards. In fact, you can go back to any operator and change the settings as you need it. Here we are in mesh from strand again. In mesh from strand, we can control the poly count here by increasing the number of sides and change the shape of the hair cards using the cross-section ramp. The next operator we are going to use is rotate, which will help us to reorient the hair cards toward the scalp. Turn on the orient based on the strand shape option and use the global angle to rotate as needed. Also, in Edit Guides, you have a button to rotate the strands. That's going to be very useful at some point. And of course, you can now groom your polygon hairs using the Groom tools in Edit Guides. Alright, let's begin. I'm going to delete this hair, selecting the hair shape and pressing the Delete key. And then create a new Ornatrix hair system. I don't need these two operators for now, let's delete them to keep it simple. I want this hair style to be symmetrical, so I will choose a uniform guide distribution. Delete half of the guides and add a symmetry operator. You may have to change the symmetry axis using the Edit Symmetry Plane button and rotating the symmetry plane. I deleted the guides that I'm not gonna use and start brushing the hair in brush mode. I use the Plant Guides tool to add more guides here and there where it's needed. As I did before, I will convert these guides into hair and use guides as hair as distribution type. This way, I will have the same amount of hair as guides without any interpolation. I am tweaking the length of the hair strands and then convert the hairs into polygon using the mesh from strands operator. As before, use the rotate operator to reorient the polygons as you need. As you can see, the mirrored side is not rotating the same as the left. This is because these hairs are not grounded to the distribution mesh. You can solve this by turning on ground mirror strand in the symmetry operator. And we are pretty much done with this part of the hair. Maybe a few tweaks here and there to fix some intersection and plant some new guides to cover any gaps you can find. Using Adopt Shape will create new guides following the existing strands, and also you can control the length of those new guides. This is more closer to the end result, but I have used the exact same method. I created a second ornatric hair system in the same scalp and used the same operators to shape the polygon hairs. I am selecting and using the move brush, the rotate strand tool, and planting new guides to cover some gaps and fix intersections. Even at this point, we can go back to guides from surface and change the point count to control the poly count, or use the detail operator to do the same. Now we are ready to make the UVs. As I said before, in Mesh from Strands, you have many options to control how UVs are generated and even add several UV sets. But for now, I only need to turn on the Per Strand Coordinates option. This will generate a UV island for each hair strand or polygon hair. I am going to extract one hair card or strand, go to the UV editor and hit the unfold button to relax the UVs. Then I click the straighten shell to have a rectangular UV island. Okay, now we can use transfer attributes here to copy this UVs to the rest of the hair cards, or we can do it manually by selecting them and scaling. Okay, now all the polygon hairs have the exact same UVs, making it very easy to texture the hair. Now let's do the same with the rest of the hair and done! That's all for this video. In the next tutorial we are going to use Ornatrix to create and bake hair maps for real-time hair shading. If you have any questions or doubts, please leave it in the comment section. You can also contact me directly to this email or via our social medias or forums. Take care and see you in the next video.